Hello everyone, my name is Shreya Singh and I am here to tell you a beautiful story written by Oscar Wilde, and the story name is The Happy Prince. In this story, there was a beautiful statue named The Happy Prince and it was high above the city. There was a little swallow who wanted to go to Egypt, so he flew all the day, and at night he arrived in the city where the statue of Happy Prince was placed. He was searching for a place to stay there at night, then he saw the statue and determined to stay there. When he was preparing himself to go to sleep, a large drop of water fell on him. He was very curious by that incident because the sky was totally clear. Then the second drop fell and then the third. At last he stood and looked up. He saw the Happy Prince was weeping. He asked to the Happy Prince, "Who are you and why are you weeping?" The Happy Prince replied, "I am the Happy Prince and I am weeping because when I was alive and had a human heart, I lived in a palace where sorrow was not allowed to enter and I was really very happy. But when I died, people of my city put me here up so high from where I can see the misery of my city, and because my heart is made up of lead, so I cannot choose just weep." He continued that far away in a little street there is a poor house. One of the window of the house is opened. From where I can see, a woman is embroidering flower on a satin gown. Her boy is lying ill in the corner of the room. He wanted oranges, but her mother had nothing to give him except river water. He requested to the swallow to pluck his ruby from his sword hilt and gave the woman. So he plucked the ruby and flew to the woman's house. He saw the woman was sleeping because she was tired. So he put the ruby behind her thimble and flew back to the Happy Prince. The next morning he went to the river and had a bath, and when the moon rose he came to the Happy Prince to bid him goodbye. The Happy Prince said that far away a man is sitting in his garret. He is trying to complete his play, but it is too cold enough to complete, and he is hungry too, and hunger made him faint. He requested to the swallow to stay with him one night longer more and help the man. At first again the swallow refused, but at last he agreed. The Happy Prince said that plucked the sapphire from his eye and gave it to the man. The swallow plucked the sapphire from the Happy Prince's eye and flew to the man's garret and put it behind the wicked wallet on the table. Again on the next morning he went to the river and had a bath, and when the moon rose he came to the Happy Prince to bid him goodbye. The Happy Prince said that in the square below there's a match girl whose all matches had fallen in gutter, and she is crying because her father will beat her if she will not bring money at home. He requested to the swallow to stay with him one night more longer and help the woman. He said that pluck my second sapphire and give it to the little match girl. The swallow refused because he know when he will pluck the second sapphire, the Happy Prince will be totally blind. He refused, but the Happy Prince said, "Do as I command you." So he plucked the second sapphire and he darted down fastly and put the sapphire in the little girl's palm, and the little girl became very happy. After helping the little girl, the swallow came to the Happy Prince and said to Happy Prince that, "I will stay with you forever." But the Happy Prince said that, "You should go now. You helped me a lot." But the swallow said, "Now I will not leave you. I will stay with you." The next morning, the swallow sat on the Happy Prince's shoulder and told him what he had seen in these days. The Happy Prince said that, "Flee over my city and tell me what you see there." The swallow flew over the city and saw the rich were making merry in their houses and the poor were sitting on their gates. When he flew to the bridge, he saw two boys lying on each other's shoulder under the archway. And when the watchman came, he said that, "You must not lie here." So they wandered in rain. The little swallow flew back to the Happy Prince and told what he had seen. The Happy Prince said that, "My whole body is covered with fine thin leaves of gold. Pluck it one by one and give it to the poor." As he said, the little swallow plucked all the thin leaves of gold and gave it to the poor, and the poor became very happy. Day by day, the little swallow got colder and colder. At last, when he knew that he was going to die, he came to the Happy Prince and said, "I am going." The Happy Prince replied that, "I am very happy that you are going to Egypt." So the little swallow said, I'm not going to Egypt, I'm going to the house of death. He asked the happy prince to kiss him on his hand. So the happy prince said, "You stayed very long and helped me a lot, so you must kiss me on my lips." So the little swallow kissed him on his lips and fell down dead. At that moment, a curious crack sounded inside the statue, and it was of the leaden heart which was snapped in two. Early the next morning, the mayor came in the square below with his town councillor, and when he saw the statue of Happy Prince, he said to his town councillor that it is much better than a beggar. And when he saw the swallow in his feet, he said, "Make an order that birds are not allowed to die here." The mayor ordered his town councillor to pull the statue. So they pulled the statue and they melted the statue in the furnace, and they found the leaden heart was not melting. So they threw the leaden heart in a heap of dust where the swallow was also lying. One day God said to one of his angels that, "Bring me two most precious things from the city." And the angel brought the leaden heart and the swallow. The God said, "You have chosen right. The swallow will sing in my garden of paradise, and the happy prince will praise me in my city of gold." So this was the story of Happy Prince. Now what we learn from this story? As we can see, the happy prince sacrificed his all precious thing which made him beautiful, and the swallow sacrificed his life just to help the poor and needy one. And because of their sacrifice, God declared them the most precious thing.